Here, in his 4,000-acre nature reserve in southern Bavaria, Frank Tutankhamun has dedicated his life to preserving mice. We spoke to his nearby neighbor, Mrs. Betty Weiss.
Hello.
Hello.
Mr. Tutankhamun claims that he has 8 white mice roaming these mountains and hills.
Well, there's one over there. There's 2 of the little fellows on this plateau here. And I think old Squeaky is up on that mountain there.
Many wildlife preservationists have questioned the need for preserving 8 mice on these 4,000 acres when there are over 60 million of them in nearby Stuttgart alone.
Just be another few minutes.
But Mr. Tutankhamun is undaunted by criticism and has recently opened a national fish park, 600 acres of pasture and woodland where cod and herring can wander freely. Visitors can drive through the preserve and look at the fish, provided, of course, they don't leave their cars. The fish wardens work hard, but so far this year, the fish park has only had 6 visitors, less than most other zoos, indeed, less than most private houses. We asked the Peruvian Minister of Pensions why this was.
Well, I suppose it may be... because...
He hadn't a clue. But it's mice that are the big business here, and every Monday, Frank Tutankhamun rides out to count his herd. He takes with him 3 of his most tough and hardened mouse boys. This is mouse country, where a man can ride for days and days without seeing his auntie. But suddenly they're in luck. Frank has spotted a mouse, and the chase is on. If it's a mouse Frank hasn't seen before, it's taken back to the ranch, broken in by a mouse boy, and branded with a big S. Whilst the mouse herds trample their way south, up in the hills there are solitary men seeking the even greater rewards that lie in these mountains. The single magic word that has tantalized man since the dawn of history. Chickens! Gabby has spent 50 years panning for chicken. He, like many other prospectors, remembers the great chicken rush of 49 when this whole river ran with chickens. Then they were defeated by primitive methods. Now they're defeated by progress.
Chicken bar! We struck chicken!
The big chicken in my... off and north at Dakota.
I'm sorry. The big chicken mines of North Dakota are located in this particular geological strata. As you can see, volcanic activity has caused these igneous rocks to expand up through the alluvial shales, revealing these rich veins of chicken here.
The men who mine these chickens work at the chicken face for long and hard hours in appallingly noisy conditions, sometimes going for weeks without seeing their aunties. Nowadays, every possible means is being used to tap the world's hen resources.
bird chicken from up the creek.
I'm sorry, Gabby. That ain't no chicken at all.
What?
It's a fake, Gabby.
Yes, the first forged chickens had appeared.
This Rhode Island Red was a cleverly reconstructed rabbit. This Suffolk Bantam was a hollowed-out eagle stuffed with lizards and badgers. This Kentish Pullet turned out to be a Mr. S.P. Stebbins.
This herd of broilers was made out of a single camel. A most interesting development, but not nearly as interesting as this man, who makes his living...
You shut up and get out of here. I'm busy.
Oh, sorry. Yes, Heinrich Bonner is a professional flea buster, capturing, breaking, and training wild fleas for Europe's leading flea circuses. This year, he's also one of Germany's big hopes in the Olympic three-day flea dressage event, and looks a sure bet to come away with a medal. Good luck, Heinrich. Huh?